carrying coffins. Well, hello everybody, and welcome back to a mod showcase. So today, guys, we are playing the God Items mod, and of course, this is 1.7.10 on Forge, and this mod is created for you guys to play with your friends, and just in general, enjoy the new aspects of PvP, and all these new god weapons and swords and stuff like that. So let's get right into the mod. Okay guys, so the first set of armor that I'd like to showcase is actually the lapis armor. Where is that? Okay, nope, it's not there. It's right over here. So we got lapis armor. And of course, you make that by... Oh god, there's zombies! Okay, lapis armor can be combined with stone shards to create this. The thunder armor, which is pretty much a god armor. This and the reaper armor are demon slash god armors. So we're gonna start by showing you the crafting recipes. It's pretty basic. I mean, it's all just the regular crafting recipes you would find in regular armor. So now that we're done with that, we can show you now that you get speed, and it's pretty basic. I mean, you get 5 armor bars and nothing really special. So yeah, that is the lapis armor. We're just gonna put this back. The next thing I like to show you is the emerald armor. Same deal. You can make it by crafting it with emeralds. Nothing too special. So we're gonna put this arm and see what happens. It's pretty much stronger than diamond. Actually, no, it's not stronger than diamond. It's pretty much just in between iron and diamond armor. You get haste. So that's pretty nice. And so the next thing we're going to show you is the bone armor. You make this by doing the same layout but with bones, and there you go. Nothing too special. All you get is night vision. Pretty nice. So I'm going to show you the crafting recipe for the god armors, which are pretty much the strongest. So what you're actually going to need is that you're going to need a lot of these. For the storm armor, which we are starting off first, I believe you need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so I know I did wrong, guys. So apparently it's supposed to be full durability. So you would need full durability, lapis chest plates, and then one storm shard in the middle, and you'll get a thunder chest plate. Put the storm shard in the center with pants, and that is what you get. You get thunder leggings. Great. Great job. I like it. I like it. Here's a crafting recipe for the helmet. My bad, you just put this here. It's actually very expensive if you add all of this together, and you pretty much get that. The crafting recipe for the lapis, for the storm boots actually, are just this, and then you put this in the center. There we go. So it's fairly expensive. I would probably not implement this in survival, since I'm not sure if you can actually get that much in a short amount of time, but you guys could try it. It's really nice. So let us test this out. Test out the armor right here, slash game mode S, and wow, this feels amazing. So it's pretty darn cool. I have no clue how to use this thunder hammer. All I know is that it does 8.5 damage. It applies a lot of really cool stuff to it. Let me just quickly read on the stuff that it gives. The Thunder Hammer does 8.5 damage. The effects are Snare, cast Slowness 3 on an entity hit for 3 seconds. It is indefatigable. 100% on kill to gain 1.5 hunger, 25% on hit to gain 1.5 hunger. It's hardened, no durability lost on entity hit. Hurricane reduces summoning fatigue by 5% per 75 kills. Summoning fatigue reduced by 10% when raining. The ability, of course, you right click, summon the Wrath of the God. Summon Lightning Ball on Graticule, and the Thunder Set 4x4 bonus will prevent damage from lightning. Pretty much what that is saying is that you can actually get like thunder, and it's pretty amazing. You get strength 1 when it's not raining, and you get strength 2 when it is raining. Okay guys, so we have the Reaper armor right now. Of course it does full armor bars. It gives you slowness in the daytime and night vision and fire resistance and water breathing. When you do time set night or when you're PvPing at night, you end up getting actually speed and all that good stuff. So what the Reaper sight does is that when you right click, it actually, I have no clue, it turns leaves into cobblestone, wood into cobblestone. It will turn plant and vegetation into dead bush. It will of course turn, it will just turn grass into dirt and cause fire and stuff like that and mayhem. So it pretty much gives your opponent wither effect. We'll read it right off here. So the Reaper Sight does plus 4.5 damage. Effect is DK, cast Wither 2 on an entity for 4 seconds, reaping. 100% on a kill gives you 1 heart, 25% on a hit to receive 1.5 hearts. It's hardened, no durability loss on entity hit. It's crucible, it gains 0.5 attack damage per 75 kills. And you can step to the void, teleport player to gratitude, changes water to ice, yeah, and all that good stuff. And it gives the entity slowness 6 for 2 seconds during the daytime. Yeah, so we're gonna kill this bugger. There we go, haha! Okay guys, I'll be honest, to create the thunder hammer thing and the scythe, it's really difficult. It is some hardcore crafting, I'm not even kidding. So what you're going to do is you're going to do this, and I'm pretty sure it's that, there we go. We get the Reaper Scythe construct, and then after that, let me just check for a second of what to do next. What are those? What are those? Okay, so I put all the modded stuff in here. You get Essence of Flame. I have no clue where you get that, but you put it in here like... very confusing. Very confusing format, in my opinion. You gotta do this, and this, and this, and the two corners, and you put this in the middle. Come on, and then you get the Reaper Scythe. Yeah. So, the same confusing crafting recipe somehow applies to the Thunder Hammer. We're gonna go on to that. Okay, so the Thunder Hammer, we're gonna go right on to this. The crafting recipe is as follows. You do this first. And two gold blocks, and then you get a Thunder Hammer construct, which isn't actually the Thunder Hammer, which, I don't know, to me it's very expensive. It's pretty much the same format as the scythe, but in an opposite way. And so yeah, that's how you construct it. We're gonna go on to the foods and special items. Okay guys, so we have an extra heart right here. I have no clue what this does. I guess if you drink it, you get one extra heart. That's actually really cool. Just keep drinking these and you get stacked. Like, no one will want to fight you. We get a damage buff. You use it. It's like a potion, actually. And then you get... you gain 0.5 hearts of extra damage. Same with the blaze charge. Actually, I don't know what that does. So, don't ask me. You get fried eggs. I have no clue how this applies to being a god. But, yeah. These are just stuff that you eat. Nothing quite special about it. It's just regular stuff. So if you drink, what's this purple drink, what happens? Okay, so I guess you get speed 2 and jump boost 2 for about 4 seconds or whatnot. I have no clue. Vodka and grain alcohol. So if you drink grain alcohol, I guess you just get slowness, strength, nausea, and resistance. A really weird combo of effects. Whoa. Jeez, this is not cool. Can I give myself some milk? It's only like 3 more seconds. Once you've... I don't know what that does. I guess it just gives you strength. So if you drink vodka, you get the same thing, actually. So, yeah. Kids, don't drink alcohol. It's pretty bad. I mean, if you want to party, sure, but don't drink too much. Okay guys, so I will send a link down below to the mod download. Of course, if you guys did enjoy, be sure to leave a like, a comment, and a subscribe. And be sure to be feel free to just tell me a mod that I could showcase and show you guys. So, hope you guys did enjoy the video. Bye bye.